Hello everyone, I'm your host Anushka and you are watching E7 News. Let's begin today's bulletin. For farmers of Devikunte in Chikkaballapur district, it's an arduous trek every day across the border into Andhra Pradesh in search of green patches for the cattle. Ever since, a forest fire burnt the pastures near their village. That's just one part of their problem. After crossing over, they are faced with resistance from locals there. Devikunte is amongst the remote villages of Bagepalli Taluk on the Karnataka-Andhra border. Cattle from not just here, but also surrounding villages like Pichavarra, Jillapalli, Honampalli and Madapalli were usually brought to the grazing ground. Villagers pointed out that after the good rain this year, there was plenty of grass across the region. But as the harsh summer set in, the grass dried up. When there was a forest fire in early March, the grassy patches nearby also caught fire. And it was so intense that it took about 4 days to douse. Devikunte has some 86 houses and many of the family rear cattle. A few of them with one or two heads of cattle are managing by feeding them vegetable peels and other greens. With 4,991 fresh COVID-19 cases reported on Wednesday alone, Bengaluru will be the focal point of discussion for Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa on Thursday when he participates in a video conference with the Prime Minister Narendra Modi along with the Chief Ministers of other states. Bengaluru is among the top 10 cities contributing to the surge in COVID-19 cases in the country as the second wave of infections have returned stronger. With the union government allowing vaccination centers to be set up at workplaces as well, Karnataka is expected to push for a more steady supply of vaccines to ensure that shortage does hamper the drive. As on Wednesday, the state had completed inoculating 3,50,404 healthcare workers, 94,748 frontline workers, 10,227 citizens in the 45-59 age group, and 37,278 citizens aged over 60 with the second dose of the vaccine. Bus services were affected in many parts of the state as drivers and conductors of the four road transport corporations began their indefinite strike over wage-related issues on Wednesday. Passengers travelling to and from distant areas and office-goers were the almost affected. Hundreds of commuters were left stranded at bus stations across the city with BNTC buses staying off the roads. While some waited long hours at bus stations for private buses, others looked for alternative arrangements. Some even opted to work from home or postpone their travel. Many made a beeline to Namma metro stations to reach their destinations, even as bus stations and terminals wore a deserted look. To ensure that commuters do not suffer further, the state government is planning to invoke the Essential Services Maintenance Act, ESMA. Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa declared in Belagavi on Wednesday. A 15-year-old boy who lost his father to coronavirus was allegedly thrashed by a school staffer for not paying the tuition fee of Rs. 5,000. Mohammad Thala, class 10th student of a Vinayaka Saraswati Convent English Medium School on a Ballari Road in Povagada, went to the school to attend extra coaching classes when the incident happened. Secretary Ashwatha Narayana beat me up with a stick in front of students after Hindi teacher Ramakrishna Naik complained that I was not studious. They scold me daily for not paying the school fee. Due to the pressure of clearing school fee dues, I am unable to concentrate on studies, the boy said. Thala lost his father, Khalid Ahmed, to COVID-19, whereas his mother, Farzana Begum, and older brother, Mohammed Taufik, recovered from the infection. The family had to spend 5.5 lakhs on hospital expenses in October last year. That's it for today. If you have any news to share, you can contact us at 1800-891-3722.